We are living in a world where communication has never been easier. Sharing ideas, telling stories, and connecting with people all over the world is fantastic, and it allows for people to learn and expand their horizons in ways which were previously not possible. Platforms like YouTube have allowed individuals to create and share content to a worldwide audience with topics based around entertainment, education, lifestyles, and more. But while this is going on, many governments and private companies are pursuing avenues to limit and censor what is shared online. Many social media websites have introduced new terms of service agreements to their platforms in the last 5 years. As an example, YouTube introduced new policies in 2019 that were reportedly meant to combat hate speech on the site, but these newly implemented policies led to things like educational history channels to be deleted without warning. Now, much more extreme instances of censorship can be found in places like Saudi Arabia, where Jamal Khashoggi, a journalist who was known for criticizing the Saudi royal family, was murdered while traveling in Istanbul in 2018. Another extreme case is China, where the Chinese Prime Minister Xi Jinping has banned the image of Winnie the Pooh across the country as people were reportedly using the cartoon character as a satirical depiction of him.
And while China has never exactly been known as a haven for free expression, he has clamped down noticeably on any form of dissent whatsoever.
There is dissent online, and China's censors are working hard to quash it. They temporarily ban the use of phrases such as personality cult and my emperor, and also references to Winnie the Pooh, a character long used to mock Xi Jinping based on an apparent resemblance.
Now, many censorship efforts, like YouTube's policies on hate speech, are usually justified by the argument that it's for our own good. Indeed, it becomes difficult to stand in opposition to these sort of things, like hate speech laws, because doing so can almost vilify you on the spot. How could you ever be against such a thing? And this is the crux of the issue, is that I am against hate speech in all its forms, but I do also believe that arguments like these are effectively gaslighting against what are actually legitimate concerns over the freedom of expression. It reminds me of a Mark Twain quote, where he states that censorship is telling the man that he cannot have a steak because a baby cannot chew it. It is very dangerous to allow for governments and private companies around the world to decide what information is unsuitable for the general public, what is too dangerous, and what is too complicated. And this very quickly escalates towards Orwellian visions of the future.
Under Xi Jinping, China is becoming more authoritarian, just as it has major plans for expansion onto the world stage. So the era of hide and bide is over, and the era of do as we say may be dawning.